So the second talk is about the phytosanitary status of false cotton moth on pears. As I've mentioned before, it's an important pest. If we look at the current distribution, it occurs in Africa, some of the surrounding islands, and also in Israel. And because of the economic damage that it causes, the countries around this region do not want the pest present. In 2013, EPO conducted a pest risk analysis to see if FCM presents a risk to the region, and they did indeed find that it does present a risk and that management measures should be identified. This resulted in a potential threat to market access for a variety of crops which have been listed as hosts of FCM, but there is some uncertainty as to which deciduous fruit types are hosts. Recently, it has been shown that apples are not a pathway for FCM during the export process, and the aim of the study was to see if the same is true for pears. Will pears be a phytosanitary host of FCM during our export process? So to achieve this goal, we needed to determine if FCM is a host of, or if pears are a host of FCM during the physiological stage of ripeness at which the fruit are harvested for export. It's not important to know if it's a host during the green stages, nor during the overripe stages. The only stage that we're interested in is the stage at which the fruit are harvested for export. There have been some unpublished reports mentioning the presence of FCM in pears, but the physiological stage of ripeness of these pears have not been determined, and also we haven't found any interceptions of FCM from pears. So to determine non-host status, 30,000 fruit had to be inspected and be uninfested. To do this, 20 pear orchards were chosen across the Western Cape, and this included early, mid and late season cultivars. Yellow Delta traps were used to monitor moth activity in the orchards just to see if they are present or not, and this was done bi-weekly throughout the fruit season. And then to do an assessment of damage, 500 fruit had to be harvested per orchard over the three seasons, giving a total of 30,000 fruit, and these were cut, opened and inspected in the laboratory. In terms of the results, just if we look at the moths that were found in the traps, FCM were caught in all the traps throughout the seasons. Despite this, if we look at the data from the first season, the fruit data, no larvae were found inside the fruit. In the second season, unfortunately, we found one FCM larva in a Forel pear. For the last season, no FCM larvae were identified from the fruit. However, there were two larvae that could not be identified. We don't know what they were. They may have been FCM, they may have been not. In terms of statistical results, I'm just going to go over this very quickly. We basically have two scenarios. First, we assume that those two larvae that could not be identified were not FCM, so we only have one infested pair. Then the confidence that 99.99% of the fruit will be uninfested, which is an acceptable level by New Zealand, Australia and Japan, will be about 95%, which is a good level of confidence. If we, in the other scenario, assume that those other two larvae were FCM and we now have three infested pairs, statistically the confidence level basically stays the same. So it doesn't really make a difference. So to conclude, FCM was present in the fruit, so we cannot really say that it is not a host, but the risk of infestation is low. Also, to be a host, the larva should be able to develop into adults, but not only that, the adults should be able to produce viable offspring. This was not investigated, so we cannot really make comments about this. But furthermore, for establishment in an importing country, at least one breeding pair, one male and one female, must be present in a consignment. And given the low level of infestation, this doesn't seem that likely. So as a final conclusion, there seems to be a low risk for infestation and also a low risk of pairs being a pathway for FCM. Thank you.